Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, we have seen the mechanism of free convection. Now for sake of analysis of the free convection, we need to know various dimensionless number. Now let us start with the Grashoff number. Grashoff number, it is nothing but the product of buoyant force and the inertial force upon the square of viscous force. As I explained, the Grashoff number, which is indicated by capital G into small r, it is defined as the product of buoyant force and inertial force to the square of viscous force. Now let us go about a small mathematical exercise. What is buoyant force? Buoyant force is nothing but, we have seen this in the fluid mechanics, that it is nothing but the weight of the fluid displaced. So the weight of the fluid displaced is given as the rho into g into the change in volume. So now this is what we have done in case of fluid mechanics. The similar steps we are going to do here. So here rho g and the volume itself is expressed by L cube. So this is my change in volume, and then comes the role of change in temperature. The change in volume, buoyant force exists because of the change in density. The change in density itself is the product of change in temperature. That is why we need to incorporate this term over here. So this we are using by a term called beta, that is nothing but coefficient of volumetric expansion. So this is a measure for the expansion of the fluid with the change in the temperature. So the buoyant force itself can be expressed by this mathematical expression. Now let us look at the inertial force. We know the inertial force is nothing but, by the D'Alembert's principle, it is summation F is equal to mass into acceleration. So let me write this as mass into acceleration itself. So my mass I can describe as density into volume. Let me write instead of volume L cube into my acceleration is nothing but meter per second square. So instead of meter, let me write again L per second square. So finally, I am getting the term something like this. Similarly, for the viscous force, we know that Newton's law of viscosity says tau is directly proportional to du by dy. Now, I can write this tau as nothing but mu du by dy. So what is my shear force? My shear force is nothing but tau into the cross-sectional area. So I can write this as mu a du by dy. So this is my viscous force. Now let us again try to solve this. Let me write mu as the kinematic viscosity upon density, and let me write this du as, let us write instead of du, if suppose the initial velocity is u, if I assume the final velocity is 0, then I can write this as u minus 0, that is u itself, and let's say the thickness is t. Now if I want to express the same thing, my area can be written as L square, u can be written as meter per second, that is L per second, and time itself can be written as 1 upon L. So finally, this can be written as, let us write mu itself, mu L square upon S. Now let us put everything in the same expression and see what we are getting. So here the GR number is written as, again let me write buoyant force into inertial force into the viscous force the whole square. Now let us write down these mathematical expressions. The buoyant force is density g into L cube into delta t. So this was my buoyant force. Then let me write the inertial force. The inertial force was rho L cube L upon this divided by the square of viscous force. Now let us try and solve this and let us see what we are ending up with. So obviously this becomes density square into g. Let us keep this L cube as it is, into delta t here, and here also we got 1 L raised to 4 upon S square. Now this divided by, again this is nu square upon delta square, and this can be written as again L raised to 4 upon S square. So now again if I start solving this, I can end up writing, this is nothing but so if you start solving for these variables, we are going to end up into something like this. Now here basically we can say that the Grashoff number is nothing but rho beta into delta t. Now this accounts for Boynt's force per unit mass into L cube upon the square of kinematic viscosity. Now this is the formula, which is a very important formula for the Grashoff number. Now what is the significance of the Grashoff number? This plays a similar role that a Reynolds number plays in force convection. So basically Reynolds number decides the type of flow in case of force convection. We know that Reynolds number itself is given as rho vd upon nu. Now there the velocity term is coming into picture. Velocity was responsible for the flow in case of force convection, and delta t is what responsible for the flow in case of natural convection. That is why the delta t is coming to the Grashoff number. So both of them play the equivalent role in force and free convection respectively. Then the second thing is for vertical plate. For vertical plate, if the GR number is more than 10 raised to 9, then the flow can be termed as turbulent, or else that will be a laminar flow. So based on this number, now again this is the empirical relationship, this thing they have found by conducting many experiments, but we can conclude that for natural convection, if the Grashoff number is more than 10 raised to 9, then the fluid flow around the body must be the turbulent, or else it has to be the laminar one. Similarly, we can say that higher the thermal expansion, obviously if the beta value is more, thermal expansion will be more, then higher will be the Grashoff number. Again, the temperature difference, if more the temperature difference, then more will be the change in density, and hence the heat transfer rate will be more, and more will be the Grashoff number. Similarly, for the kinematic viscosity, lesser is the kinematic viscosity, higher is the Grashoff number. Now that is all in this topic. In this topic, we tried to understand what is Grashoff number, its mathematical formula, and its significance. That's it in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.